children. Yes, now we'll go towards the next subject, that is general knowledge, GK. So before that, this is the book, or this is the textbook of the general knowledge, that is New Find Out. This is our textbook for the general knowledge, that is New Find Out. Okay, and the textbook has been arranged in 7 different sections. Okay, this textbook has been arranged in 7 different sections. They are My India, Look, Think and Answer, Plants and Animals, Language and Literature, The Environment, World and Its People, Science and Us, and last one is Culture, Sports and Fun. So these are the different sections which we are going to see in this textbook. Okay, now according to index we are going to start our first section, that is Plants and Animals. The first section is Plants and Animals. Let's go. So the first one is Wildlife Quiz. Means on this page the questions are asked about the wildlife. But before that, what is meant by wildlife, or the how birds and animals they are living, we'll see here. The birds are beautiful creatures which attracts our mind near homes or near the pasture land. We all are very interested about the wildlife or about the birds and animals. We are very eager to know about them, that how they are living, because they can't talk at all. So how they are communicating with each other, how the lifestyle they are living in the jungle or where it has their habitat is there. Okay, so the birds are a beautiful creatures which attracts our mind near homes or near the pasture land. Their sweet chirping, laughing and twittering make us happy and delightful, especially about the cuckoo. We like it all the time. The birds, big or small, always recreates our mind into a very fascinating way, whether they are catching insects or taking food grains from the ground. They always impress us from their acts of moving or flying here and there on the earth. Especially about the small children, the little children, they are very eager and always they are very curious about them. Isn't it? If we saw any bird or any insect like this, then we are very eager to see how it flies, how it moves, how he is flattering his wings up and down. Isn't it? So we all are interested about this animal world or this bird's world. See here. Wild animals and birds are most comfortable in their own homes or habitats. Isn't it? Even we people also, we are very comfortable at our home. So what are the habitats of this wild animals or of this wildlife? Forest, jungles, oceans, caves and trees. Isn't it, children? So these animals, birds, they are very comfortable in their own homes. That is where we should leave them, and it is the place where we should leave them. Most of the time, these animals or birds, they are very enjoying with the nature only. Isn't it? That is what it is known as wild animals or wildlife. Understood about the wildlife? So let's see about it. Now, here are some pictures given. You can see the pictures, isn't it? And we have to identify these creatures that look so relaxed in their natural home. Now tell me one thing, when you are in the school, So how your behavior is like this, that you are sitting very quietly and you are listening to your teacher and all. But when you are at your home, that time you are very relaxed, very happy, jumping, doing masti and all these things. Isn't it? So this thing is also same with the birds and animals. When they are in the cage, they are not that much happy or satisfied. And when they are in the nature, natural home, they are very relaxed and enjoying their lifestyle. Isn't it? Now, let's identify the creature that looks so relaxed in their natural home. Now, we'll see here, help box is also given. What are the options? Heron, gaur, piranha, bulbul, nilgai, badger, beaver. So these are the options. And now this is the picture. Let's see. Yes. So this is the first picture. So what do you think? Which one is the correct answer? This is the picture of a bird. So the first one is bulbul. The first picture is of bulbul. So everyone, you have to write there bulbul. The spelling is given in the help box. Written? Very good. Now the second picture is of what? Again. Look at the help box. The second picture is of heron. That is H-E-R-O-N. You have to write down there. Yes. Very good. Now the third picture is of fish. I think so. Just like fish. So what is the name of that? It is piranha. P-I-R-A-N-H-A. It is piranha. Yes. Now the fourth picture. The fourth picture is gaur. G-A-U-R. It is gaur. Everyone you are writing, no? Very good. It is gaur. The fifth one is beaver. What is the fifth one? Beaver. Very good. Now this sixth one is, isn't it looks like cow? So what do we call it? Yes. The animal which is in that picture is known as nilgai. That is N-I-L-G-A-I. Nilgai. Everyone, you all are writing, no? The spellings are there in the help box, so you have to write it. So the sixth one is nilgai. And the last, that is seventh one picture is of what? Which is that animal? What is the last option which is remaining in the help box? That is badger. What is the name of this animal? It is badger. Yes. So understood, children? In this way, we solve this question, which is from the page number 7. Got it? Any doubt, children? If you have any doubt, please note down it, or please you can ask me by mail. So, have you understood? Yes. Now, let's go move forward. Now children, here is the question given, that is question number B, which you have to do at home. See here, what is given. In your own find out book, paste the pictures of creatures similar to the ones on this page and don't forget to name them. It means we have to collect the pictures of different birds and animals from the another book, or you can collect it from the net also. And you have to paste it, but don't forget to write down the names. You have to write the name also below that each picture. And here, find out a simple fact about each of the animals, fish and birds on this page. If it is possible, you can solve this. I will show you one example. Here, I have collected some pictures. See here. So these are the pictures. These all pictures are of birds. So you can collect it like this, different birds, different wild animals, and you can paste it. And below that, you have to write down the name of that particular bird or animal. Will you do it? Everyone understood what you have to do here? Yes, very good. Now we'll go towards next page. The next page is life in the ocean. Now we saw about the life of wild animals, how they are living and how their lifestyle. Now here we will see about the life in the ocean, and especially we all are very eager to know about the life in the ocean. How the animals or the creatures, they are living below the sea, in the water, how they are breathing, how they are eating, how they are moving, how they are communicating with each other. So it is totally different than us, isn't it? So we'll see life in the ocean. See, here is the picture which is in the ocean. See the different creatures of the aquatic animals. Yes, see here. Now children, there is a one world inside the water. This world contains many animals and plants. These animals are called as aquatic animals. They have their separate lifestyle. These animals live completely different from normal living beings. They have an entirely different respiratory system. Yes, children, why the different respiratory system? Because we can breathe by the air, isn't it? But how it is possible under the water that one should breathe? So though they are living in the water, but it should be easy for them to breathe. They have the different respiratory system. Their respiratory system has provision to breathe inside the water, but not on the ground or land area. Means they can easily breathe in the water, but not on the ground. Aquatic animals take oxygen inside the water. Therefore, it is said that aquatic life is very much different and opposite to the normal terrestrial life. With increasing water contamination and spilling of oils in seas and water bodies, and increasing incidence of trapping activities by humans, this aquatic life is trapped in danger situation. Yes, children, nowadays the people, we are only polluting the water, and because this water is very harmful for this aquatic animal, isn't it? So we have to take care of it, and we have to preserve them, the aquatic life. Then only we can see, you know, the different lifestyle, isn't it? So understood everyone about the life in the ocean? Now let's see. Here I collected some pictures. Which are related to the life in the water or life in the sea. These all are aquatic animals, and we can imagine that how the animals, plants, fishes, they can live in the water. See here, jellyfish is there, starfish, then seahorse. Got it? So this is, we can say that the life in the sea or in the ocean. Yes. Now, related to this aquatic animals, we have to write down the name of the creatures found in the water bodies. Here the pictures are given and explanation is also there. See here. The first one is, it lives in and by the sea, walks and swims sideways, and can carry its own house. So what is this picture is of? Yes, it is crab. Second one, a dangerous hunter in the sea. It has deadly teeth and huge jaws. Jaw means? This is mouth, wide open mouth. It is called jaw. So what is that animal is called? It is shark. Third one, although it lives under the sea, it is a mammal, needs air to breathe and needs it feeds its baby milk. And this animal or this type of fish is known as? What is the picture about? Just think. Yes, it is whale. Got it? So, in this way, we have named these creatures which are found in the water bodies. You all are writing the answers, no? Very good. Now, question B. Unscramble the letters and name these creatures. So, these are also the creatures which lives in the water. Letters are given, but not in the sequence. We have to write the names of these aquatic animals. The first one, S-A-N-W-R-P. And what is the answer of it? Yes, it is prawns. Second one, S-J-E-F-L-Y, F-I-Y, double L-H. What is this picture about? Yes, it is jellyfish. Third one, I know you can say it easily because you know about this animal and this is known as seahorse. Very good, correct. I hope you all are writing the answers in the textbook because when our school will start, I am going to check your books. Very good. Written? Yes. So you understood how to write the answers? Any doubts, children? Yes. Now the next page. Now on this page number 8, there is one thing which is given. Did you know? So what is the new information? See here. Some fish are not fish shaped at all. Means we know what the fishes are in which shape. But some fishes are not in the fish shape at all. The prickly porcupine fish gulps down water and blows itself up like a balloon to scare away its enemies. See here, you can see in the picture that is porcupine fish who blows his body like a balloon. Why? Because to scare away its enemies. But this is also the type of fish. In China, food items such as shark fins are considered in 2013. The Chinese government prohibited the consumption of dishes containing shark fins, bird's nest, and wild animals products at official dinners. See, it means killing them, hunting them. It is not good. It is banned by the government only. So we have to take care of them. And we have to preserve them. Yes. So now, from the next page, word games are given, which is related to language and literature. So, this word game is related to language and literature you need. So let's see what is given over here. The answer to sentence B in each question formed by adding a letter or letters to the answer to sentence A. For example, a male animal is called bull. A small metal object fired from a gun is called bullet. It means the answer of the question A is given. And by adding some letter or letters in it, we have to write the answer of question B. Have you understood, children? Very good. So first one, a young goat is called kid. K-I-D, kid. And question B, to take a person away by force What do we call them? To take a person away by force. So what do we call it? To take a person away by force, without asking him, without knowing him. Yes, kidnap. It means KID, kid, we keep it as it is and only we added NAP, that is kidnap. Understood how to solve? Only we have to add few letters in the answer of the question A and we have to write the answer of question B. Very good. Now second number, a place where ships can take shelter. For example, a place where all trains are there or where all STs, buses are there. So what do we call it? Yes, we can call it as a bus stand or railway station, like that. So like that, a place where ships can take shelter, it is known as port. And the question B, a part or a share? Question B, a part or a share? So what we call it? Is it portion? P-O-R-T-I-O-N. It is portion. Third number, an insect. We call it bug. B-U-G. An insect, we call it as bug. Now, a musical instrument that is blown. See here, picture is given. A musical instrument that is blown. So what do we call it? It's a bugle. B-U-G-L-E. Only we added L-E to it. Fourth number, the price. What do we call it? The price. It is cost. What is it? It is cost. Now B option is special clothes. What do we call to special clothes? Yes, it is costume. What do we call it? It is costume. It means C-O-S-T-U-M-E-S. Costume. Understood? So have you understood how to solve the question number A? Very good. If you have any doubt, any query, you can ask me by mail. Then we'll move towards the question number B. Now fill in the missing letters to complete the words. Only we have to fill in the missing letters. Clue is given. First one, we buy things with it. What is needed to buy things? M-O-N dash dash. What will be there? What are the letters? M-O-N-E-Y. That is money. With this help of money only, we can buy the things. If money is not there, then how should we buy? Understood? Yes. The second one, a mischievous animal. That animal is always jumping, doing masti and all. So what do we call it? A mischievous animal. M-O-N-K-E-Y. That is monkey. Very good. See, a man who lives in a monastery. A man who lives in a monastery. What do we call it? M-O-N dash. Monk. Very good. Second number. What we do in a temple, mosque or church? What we do in the temple, mosque or church? We P-R-A. What we do? We pray. P-R-A-Y. Pray. Very good. B. To dance about. P-R-A dash dash dash. To dance about. It's prance. P-R-A-N-C-E. C. Repeated training. Same thing we are doing again and again. Repeated training. What do we call it? P-R-A-C-T-I-C-E. It is practice. Very good. Third number. Arrows are shoot. at it. Arrows are shoot at it. T-A-R. In which direction we are shooting our arrows? T-A-R-G-E-T. It is target. B. A deadly spider. What do we call it? A deadly spider. T-A-R-A-N-T-U-L-A. That is tarantula. C. Waterproof covering. It is a thing which we can use to protect from the water. What we call it? Tarpaulin. What we call it? It is tarpaulin. Understood, children? So in this way, we have solved the word game question A and question B. Now here is the task given. What we have to find out? Three words in the English language that have been borrowed from Hindi, your mother tongue or a language spoken in your state. We have to find out the three words in the English language that have been borrowed from Hindi, your mother tongue or a language spoken in your state. Will you? Just think, discuss with your parents and do this activity. Okay? Let's move forward. Did you know yaj is a Dutch word, kiosk is a Turkish, and bungalow is a Hindi word? What is meant by yaj? You know this, it is just like a ship. A telephone kiosk, it means a telephone booth, and a bungalow. See, these are the three different words from different languages. So like this, with the help of like this, you have to do that activity. So, have you understood, children, what we saw today in GK's period? Yes, if you have any doubt queries, please note down it or ask me by mail. So, in this way, we have completed the wildlife quiz, again, life in the ocean and the world game. Understood? I hope you all are writing the answers in the textbook. I am going to check your textbook after the school will start. Isn't it? Till then, stay home, stay safe, and take care of yourself and your family. Bye.